Hey guys, welcome back to the DrCliffAuD vlog. This is vlog number 34, and you may have noticed that last week I did not post a vlog, and the reason I did not is because I actually took my wife on a little road trip for a few days, so I didn't actually get a chance to do a vlog last weekend, but I promise I'll make it up for you today. Really, the two things I want to talk about today. One, I'm going to talk a little bit about the trip that I just had and the reason why I wasn't able to record a video last week, and the progress on the clinic, the new clinic. I want to give you an update there. I do have some video that I want to show you with how the clinic looks right now and what we're doing to get back on track. So first and foremost, a couple weeks ago, I posted a vlog about how I spend basically all of my free time when I'm outside of the clinic working on video content for my channel. And what at the expense basically of family time. And so a lot of individuals reached out to me directly and on comments on the video saying that, Cliff, you really need to be focusing more attention on family. And so I took that to heart and actually took Ashley out of town. You know, obviously with COVID, we've been trapped inside for months now, and she's really itching to get out. Just to give you a little bit more information there, my family's from Illinois. Ashley's family is from Kansas, and because we have not been able to travel really at all this year, it's been really hard on her, hard on me, of not being able to see family. And then when we're spending all of our other free time basically working, we really needed to do something to get away. So I basically said, you know, just plan a trip. Actually, I think she kind of just took it on herself to just plan a trip, just to get out of town for a few days. And, you know, where we live in Phoenix, it's fairly simple for us just to drive up to Sedona and Prescott and Flagstaff and to take a little bit of time off. Basically, myself and Ashley are cheap dates. The only thing that we really care about anytime that we travel someplace for vacation is what we can do physical activity-wise, meaning we like to hike, we like to trail run, we like to do, you know, sightseeing, stuff like that. So basically, we just did a bunch of different hikes and trail runs, some of them more interesting than others, but I'm gonna go ahead and show you about 30 to 45 seconds of some of the different trails that we did up in Sedona and up in Flagstaff, and even the Grand Canyon is in there too. So if you're not interested in that stuff, go ahead and skip ahead. I will put a timestamp in the description of this video to show you where you can skip ahead to if you don't wanna see my 2020 slideshow of my vacation. All right, so hopefully you guys enjoyed that. And if you skipped right ahead, let's go ahead and get into the other thing that I want to talk about today, which is the new clinic update. This is something that I have not talked at all about over the course of the last 5 months. Recently, as of about 3 weeks ago, we were basically forced to change contractors. Our original contractor quit. Fortunately, we've been working with a management company, a construction management company. We were able to get their advice or their recommendation on a new general contractor that could kind of pick up the ball and keep running with it. And it's actually been a really, I would say, beneficial thing for us. It's a breath of fresh air to get a contractor in that is truly, truly good at what they do. And you can definitely tell the difference. You know, they're coming into a situation that is not perfect. I mean, they're kind of trying to figure out what the heck's going on. Why has this been done? Why has that not been done? You know, we have not really passed many inspections to this point. And I'll probably be able to explain all of that stuff in future videos. But what I want to basically show you right now is what this new contractor is walking into with this space. So let me go ahead and cut over to me taking you through a tour through the space. All right, August 28th, 2020. Let's show you what we have going on here. And sorry, I don't have my light, so hopefully there's enough natural light in here to show you what's going on. But right here, this is the front desk area. Basically, almost nothing's been done since March. So we're kind of left off where we were 5 months ago, basically. But waiting area here, you can see that not a whole lot, you know, has been done in here since I last showed you. One thing that has happened here is that we've made the hallway much smaller, so it's more narrow than what it was before, but the rooms were extended out a bit. If you look here, you can see that all of this has been extended out to give it an extra couple feet. I think it was, actually, I think right here is where they started extending it from. But you can see that it's added a little bit of depth to the rooms, which is good. And that's why we had to take some space out of the hallway. But those rooms still, they're going to be about 13.5 foot long instead of 14.5 like we had originally spec'd. And then the hallway is definitely, you know, about 1.5 foot more narrow than what it was before. And then we also took some depth out of the restrooms here. So, you know, the restrooms are still the same width here, but in terms of depth, it is a couple feet, you know, more shallow, I guess I would say. Still, of course, ADA compliant, which was the main concern there. But there's a second restroom. This right here is the second treatment room, and the third treatment room right here, still 12 foot wide. This right here is kind of that spare room, but I'll explain to you here in a minute. This is probably where the sound booth is gonna have to go just because of space requirements for the sound booth. Because as we go back here into the original sound booth area, this space was basically not done correctly. We should have had 12 foot across here, but that right there is only 9.5 foot or so. So there won't be enough room to get the size sound booth that we want in here and still have space to move around. So this will probably turn into kind of the spare room, I guess. But as we go this way, the kitchen area, this was largely unaffected. I mean, a little bit of the space was taken out from the hallway. It was shifted in about 1.5 feet here at the doorway, but you know, all the area for where the table and break room area is going to go is still the same size in there. And then our work room is basically the same size as well. It's about 11.5 foot across, so we're going to have a bunch of cabinets there, but this really wasn't affected. We had the option of taking that wall and pulling it in to give us more space in that room over there, but we decided that the workspace was more important and that we would just shift the sound booth over into this room over here. But we have a new general contractor. They came in here with the inspectors for a courtesy inspection this last week, and so we got a little bit more guidance
on what needs to be done and what's, you know, within code and what's not in code. So hopefully here pretty soon we'll be right back on track.
So there you go. I took that video this morning of me walking through the space, and the new general contractor that we have, I would have to say, is just phenomenal. He is on the ball with every little thing that's going on. He's trying to work with us to try to get it to where we can stop the bleeding of money that's been going out. We're trying to finish the space, do it in a cost-effective manner. It definitely, you know, with the issues, I mean, since mid-March is basically when we said, hold on, stop construction. And keep in mind, this has nothing to do with COVID going on. But we're really trying to get the build out of the space back on track. And based on the estimate from the new general contractor, he believes that it's going to be about 2 months between now and when we have a completely finished space that we'll be able to move into. So if you add another, you know, 15 to 30 days on top of that, a little bit of buffer time, plus the time to actually move and notify all of my patients that we are moving, we hopefully will be in there, you know, in about 3 months from now. So we're at what, end of August? So basically September, October, November, you know, hopefully before the end of the year, we'll be in to that new space. And, you know, out here in Arizona, things tend to pick up pretty quickly in the fall time when everybody comes back. In fact, you know, it's kind of a weird situation because of COVID, not all of my patients left to go to their more northern states, to their summer homes that are in cooler destinations. A lot of them actually just stuck around. But it doesn't change the fact that we'll definitely be busier in the fall, and we'd like to be in the new clinic when we are busy. We also have a new audiologist on staff, someone who came on board about a month ago. So we're in the middle of training him up to get him up to speed with how we practice inside of our clinic. And you guys will probably be seeing him on video here shortly as well. So stay tuned to get introduced to him as well. So, okay, that is it pretty much for today's vlog. Again, I apologize for not posting a vlog last week. You know, I took your guys' advice and said, you know what, I'm just gonna not do anything for a weekend filming wise and tend to some family downtime. And it was really enjoyable. So thanks for bearing with me. And I truly mean it this time when I say I will see you next week.